Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another edition in the Minnesota Vikings franchise. It is week 16, and we're almost to the end of the regular season, and the Minnesota Vikings have broken their losing streak and have won their last three games and are now actually one of the top-ranked teams in the entire league, and now they're on top of the NFC North as well. Jamel Fleming was injured in last week's matchup against the Packers, and we likely will not see him again unless the Vikings make the playoffs and go to the Super Bowl. So today's test is to take down the Chicago Bears as the Vikings try to get their 10th win of the year and stay on top of the NFC North. Vikings on offense here in the first quarter. It's first down and 20 from the 10-yard line. It's Ponder. He'll go short to Cassius Stevens, who is... He makes the catch for 8 yards and then is once again shaken up for about the 97th time this season. Third down and 17. Ponder going long and he's got Jamez Logan. He's good for a couple of deep balls every now and then. This one's good for 30 and it'll bring the Vikings to third down and 10 from their own 43-yard line. Ponder takes a shotgun snap. He'll wait, look downfield. He'll fire in the direction of Mark Harrison. It's knocked away, incomplete. And so the Vikings punt and now Jay Cutler comes out. The Bears have had a very disappointing season. And he will have a long vacation coming up shortly after the Bears miss the playoffs. First down and 10. Here comes Cutler going long. He's going to heave it into a triple or double coverage, and it's nearly intercepted by Keystone Terry. And that's going to fall incomplete, obviously. Second down and 10 now, and Cutler drops back to throw. He's under pressure. The ball's loose, and the Vikings have it. It's Phil Taylor falling out at the 10-yard line. And they'll take over possession with third down and 12 coming up. Ponder out of the gun. He'll step up in the pocket and go to the end zone. It's nearly intercepted. It's batted away. And the Vikings will take a field goal for the game's first points. Second down for Cutler as he drops back. The blitz is picked up. He'll take a shot long downfield. And it's caught by Johnny Knox somehow in the middle of double coverage. Cutler took another chance and this one actually worked. First and 10 now from the Vikings 31 as Cutler wants to run. He has room to run and he'll get a first down. Don't see that too often. 13 yards. A new set of downs now for the Bears as Cutler in the pocket being chased. And Lewis Nix takes him to the turf again. His second sack on the day. Lewis Nix causing a lot of disruption as Jay Cutler's been hurried three times already in this game. It's 3rd and 15. Cutler to throw over the middle. He'll go short to Levisky. And it's going to be good for about a gain of 9. And the Bears will be forced to tie the game with a field goal. Ponder leads the Vikings back out to the field as it's 2nd down and 20. He'll take a shot long. Deep middle. It's hauled in by Jamez Logan. His second catch of the game. This one is a 50-yard bomb from Christian Ponder. And now 1st and 10. Ponder to the outside. It's Larry Fitzgerald making a 1st down grab. 11 yards. And now it's 3rd down and goal. Three wide in the tight end for Ponder. He'll look to the end zone. Doesn't want to force it, and he's hit as he throws the ball, and it'll fall incomplete, and the Vikings will make it 6-3. Not yet out of the first quarter as the Bears have the football, and Timbers makes a wonderful spinning grab at about the 35. He'll take it to the 37-yard line, and now it's 1st and 10 as we begin the second quarter. Cooper in motion, a handoff to Matt Forte, the first handoff of this entire episode, and it's good for about 9 yards as it's close to a 1st down, but now it's 3rd and 1. They have to get to about the 48-yard line for a 1st down. Cutler will pass. He'll go deep right side. It's hauled in. Timbers beat Morris Claiborne. Remember, Jamel Fleming is out, and Timbers is down to the 11-yard line. It's a big gain, and the Bears have it inside the red zone. Second down and 7 from the 8-yard line. Hand off to Childs, off tackle right side. He'll find his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. They have the game's first touchdown. It's 10-6 as the Vikings go back out to the field now on offense. Ponder over the middle. It's Mark Harrison. They're spreading out the field this afternoon. And they're telling Christian Ponder to sling the football. Second down and 10. Ponder's going to throw again. This time, Stoneburner's got it at the 40. He's down inside the 35-yard line of Chicago. Call it a 28-yard pass play, and now it's 3rd and 9. Monty Ball in the backfield. He picks up a blitz, but then he escapes Monty Ball, and he sacks Christian Ponder. It's Jarrell Worthy, a very familiar face for this series. Now it's a 59-yard field goal calling for Sebastian Janikowski, and this one is good. 10-9, Chicago still on top. Vikings have 3 drives in Bears territory and 3 field goals. 4:12 to go in the first half as Jay Cutler takes the snap. He'll sling it downfield. It's hauled in by Lawrence. And it's a 34-yard grab, and both teams are just airing it out this afternoon. Nobody even going to the run game. And now Matt Forte proves me wrong, but he loses a couple yards in this carry, and it'll be fourth down coming up, and perhaps a long field goal. Yes, the Bears will attempt to make it a 13-9 game now as we've hit the two-minute warning, and this kick is up. It has the accuracy, but it does not have the distance. It's no good, and the Vikings have the ball with some time before halftime. Welcome, Adrian Peterson. We're very sorry for not mentioning you in this episode up until this point. There's 4 yards, and now it's 3rd and 6. Ponder to throw. Looks over the middle. It's Larry Fitzgerald making the catch, and he is down at the 45, maybe? And they're going to say that he was just shy of the first down marker. So the Vikings come on to punt. It's Chris Cluey at his own 40, and it's a snap to the upback Musil. And Musil's got a first down, a gain of 5. The Vikings whip out the fake punt, and they'll have a little bit of time to score still. 21 seconds, and Ponder over the middle. The deep grab is hauled in by Kyle Rudolph. Call it gain of about 24. 9 seconds to go, the clock running. Vikings have one timeout, maybe the last play before the half. Ponder to the end zone, and Logan, I think he's got it. Come on, signal it, ref. Touchdown! The Vikings take the lead with 3 seconds before halftime. Jamez Logan in the back corner of the end zone. That safety was definitely not aware of him, and that it must have been the Raheem Moore effect. But the Vikings have the lead now, 15-10, a failed two-point conversion, and now we'll go to the second half, and Matt Forte, he's not getting anything on the ground today. It's a loss of a couple, and now 3rd down and 7. Cutler to throw. Looking downfield. Throws over the middle, and Lavisky can't hang on. He was hitting the play by Chad Greenway, and the Vikings take over. Vikings begin this drive with a handoff to Adrian. He'll break a tackle. He's angry. He's not getting the ball this game. And that's his 7th carry. This one's good for a first down, taking the Vikings to midfield. 3rd down and 8 now. Ponder out of the shotgun. McCluster into the game now at halfback. And Ponder goes down in the backfield. It's a loss. And 4th down comes up, and the Vikings punt. Bears football, 2nd down and 8. Cutler fakes the handoff to Matt Forte, standing at his own goal line. He'll look for Lavisky, and Lavisky can't hang on again. Not doing a very good job of hauling in the catches in traffic, so now it's 3rd down and 8 from the 8, or the 6-yard line, rather. And Cutler takes a snap. All alone in the backfield, and this pass is bad. Over the middle, and inaccurate, Jay Cutler. They'll punt out of their own end zone now, and back deep is the dangerous Mark Harrison at the zone at the Chicago 48. Takes it and goes to the left side. A block picked up, and he's out of bounds to the 30-yard line. A gain of 18, and the Vikings have it already in field goal range. Adrian up the middle, and nowhere to go. Wooten comes over and tackles him after a gain of a couple, and now 3rd and 8. Ponder's going to throw, looks downfield, hit on the play, but he finds Adrian Peterson in the passing game, getting involved somehow. Anywhere he can touch the ball, he's happy with it. 2nd down and 5, Ponder's going to throw again. This time it's short to Mark Harrison across the first down line, and it's 1st and goal coming up for the Vikings. I form now, handoff, Adrian up the middle, 6 points, thank you, touchdown Adrian Peterson. The Vikings now have a 2-score lead as the big 2-8 makes the Vikings up 12, and the Bears now in the fourth quarter playing from down 2 scores. This time Lavisky's all alone, and he catches this football like he should, and it's a gain of 20 yards. The Bears now at midfield operating out of the shotgun on 2nd down and 10. Cutler takes a snap. He'll run right and right into the waiting arms of Eric Norwood, who gives him a bear hug to the ground, and now 3rd down and 15 following the sack. Cutler gonna take a shot long downfield. He has a man, and Timbers can't make the catch. Hit on the play by Ha'on Clinton Dix. Great play by the safety. Exactly what you got to do at that spot. 1st and 10 now for Ponder to the outside. It's Jamez Logan, and he has been pretty active in the passing game today. Pretty impressive. A buck 27 on 6 grabs and a score. And now 3rd and 9. This time it's Mark Harrison across the 40, and he'll be short of the first down marker, and the Vikings punch, but they do take some time off the clock, which is still considered a success at this point in the game. Bears now trying to go down the field with Shamir Haskins making a first down grab. 2nd down and 5. Empty backfield for Jay Cutler. Might as well. They haven't run the ball much all game. And this time, Timbers makes a great catch on the outside, and that's going to be a first down into Vikings territory. And the Bears are now at the 36-yard line on 3rd down and 4. Cutler wants the run. He'll fumble, and nobody can get to it until an offensive lineman falls on it. A Vikings defender was close, but He was tripped up. And now it's 4th and 3. Having it to the Vikings. 32-yard line, a man in motion moving left to right. Keller takes a shotgun snap. He'll take off to run, and he's got the first down. That looked almost drawn up, actually. But I guess you can experiment when you're not going to the playoffs. 3rd and 10 now for Jay Cutler at the 15-yard line. He takes the snap, looks to the end zone, has a man, it's knocked away at the last second. Great play on the ball by Chad Greenway. And once again, the Bears face a 4th down. They need 10 yards to the Vikings' 4. Vikings on a 4-man rush, and they can't get to Cutler. He'll go to the goal line. It's caught by Lawrence, and he'll be stopped at about the 2-yard line. Let's go to 1st and goal now from the 1 after an offsides penalty. Cutler fires to the end zone. It's a touchdown. Lavisky makes the catch in the back line of the end zone, and the Bears have a shot now. It's a 1-score game. They're down by 5. This onside kick attempt is now underway, and it's hauled in by Jamez Logan. He's got it, and the Vikings will take over, and they're a 1st down and change away from getting this game over and done with. Hand off Adrian, up the middle, and that's going to be all she wrote. The Vikings can now take a knee, and the Bears can prepare for their hour-long flight, or however it is, from Minneapolis to Chicago, so they can go home, because the Vikings are victorious, 22-17. And we'll see how the Vikings' playoff chances now look here in just a minute. Big reason why they won today was the work of Lewis Nix and the defensive line applying pressure on Jay Cutler and giving him a nightmare back at quarterback. And also, Jamez Logan was very effective today in the passing game. Not sure he even had a drop in this one, actually. So, good job, Jamez Logan. He had a big touchdown in the first half as well, and Adrian got some work in the second half and also got a score of his own. Good team win today. Both the offense and defense contributed big time to this win. And now we will take a look at the NFC North standings. Our Minnesota Vikings are indeed ending this series in the playoffs. The Vikings are 10-5 and so are the Detroit Lions. They're both going to go to the playoffs. But next week, the Vikings play the Lions. Winner wins the crown of the NFC North and is awarded a home playoff game. The stakes are high for this Week 17 matchup, and this is the way the regular season should end. We'll see you next time, guys, in the regular season finale of the Minnesota Vikings franchise series. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.